channel. If you are new here, my name is Carlene, and if you are not new, welcome back, girl. Today, we are gonna do empties, okay? Winter empties. I'm so, so excited. It's been a hot minute. We did the fall empties. I will link more down below. This will be on the empties playlist. Etc. etc. So I love empties because for me it's all about like decluttering, but at the same time letting you guys know my final thoughts on products that I have completely used up. Will I repurchase them? Will I hate them? You know, do I recommend them? Etc. We have a full bin of empties. We're also prepared with a trash bag right here. And if you guys hear any snoring or barking in the background, that's because Millie is right back there. Before I forget, do not forget to hit subscribe before you go, okay? Turn on those bell notifications, girl, if you love empties videos. I do these, I would say at least once a quarter now, okay? At least once a quarter, like once a season. I don't wanna say quarter, like that's very like businessy. But once a season, and we do fashion try-ons, hauls, etc. over here. So join the family, hit subscribe, stick around for a while. And then over on Instagram, I actually ask you guys a lot of questions, like what you guys want to see first, that kind of thing. So make sure to follow me over there for more fashion inspo. And of course, over on TikTok, where I share different outfits and how to style and whatnot. So without further ado, let's go ahead and dive in. And I'm not starting in any particular order, but I see a ton of body stuff at the beginning. So first thing that I see is the Native body wash. You guys already know how I feel about Native. Absolutely love their deodorant. That is all I use. This is in the pumpkin spice latte scent, and that's actually the deodorant that I'm working through right now. Absolutely love it. I love, love, love just the scent in general. It's just, oh my gosh, I was kind of sad that this was, you know, completely used up, but at the same time, it's like becoming more, more winter time, so I like fresher scents, but I do really love Native products, and this body wash was a favorite from, when did I get this? I feel like I've had this since August, so it lasts a long, long time too, and I would definitely repurchase. Next item that I've already repurchased and I'm obsessed with is the Palmer's Cocoa Butter. I love this stuff, you guys. This big, huge tub of cocoa butter, I'm pretty sure it was only $11. I love Palmer's Cocoa Butter. It's probably one of my favorite products of all time, and I highly recommend it. I love that there's like the pump, and I of course use other moisturizers, but this one is just like a go-to. It smells good. It hydrates the skin beautifully. It helps with scars. It's so, so good. So I could not recommend Palmer's enough. Already have a backup of this. This is the Tree Hut Firming Sugar Scrub. I don't really know about the firming portion, not gonna lie, but the mocha and coffee bean scent, oh, it smells so good. I love coffee. I do coffee with Carlene over on Sunday mornings. We got ready over there this morning with my skincare and my hair care. And then I filmed a get ready with me on this look. So, I mean, I love coffee in general. I mean, I'm from Seattle, so I love coffee in general, but you guys, this scrub in particular smells incredible, and I just love the grit of it. Some of the Tree Hut scrubs don't have that grit, but this one does, and I really, really like it, and I already have another one in my shower. All right, I've talked about this small black-owned business before, but this is Alchemistic's Jupiter Essence Soufflé. Every single item of hers comes with a crystal, first off, love it. And then on top of it, it smells absolutely amazing. I love the scent Jupiter, it smells so, so good. She already knows, I was like, girl, Tanisha, please do not ever discontinue that scent. I'm about to order more, highly recommend. It's like a whipped, but it like melts into an oil. So if you're super dry, you will love this. But I also use this during the summertime too. This is like a great lightweight, all year round moisturizer, but I really highly recommend it. She has incredible products and everything is handmade with love, and it's a small business. And I believe, don't quote me on this, I hope it still works, but you can use Queen Carlene for 25% off. I don't get anything from it. She was just like, hey, do you want this code for your followers? I was like, hell yeah. So of course, you know, spread the love and make sure you go over and support her small business. But seriously, like, her products are incredible. I'm about to place another order. We have not one, but two Native deodorants. I told you guys, I'm like obsessed with them. So we have the apple scent. This is the apple and honeysuckle. This was from the fall time. Really, really like this one. It was nice and fresh and it wasn't like too, too fruity. And then this is the grapefruit and bergamot. It's like literally coming off so I can barely see. I like this one, but it didn't smell as much as the other ones. Like, it didn't feel like I was wearing anything. So if you like more like unscented scents, then you will really like the grapefruit. But if you like something more fragrant, this one's probably not for you. I would do like the coconut and vanilla or one of their seasonal scents. But seriously, obsessed with Native deodorant. You guys already know. I need to like sit down and do a hair care journey video, like a weave video. I know a few people have requested that. And then also I need to do a natural deodorant journey, because I seriously, like, I will never go back to regular deodorant. So anyway, highly recommend Native. Really, really love these. All right, this is a new one, and I am actually TMI on my period right now, but I will say that these actually worked, and I am, of course, going to continue to use them and monitor how I feel, but this is the Flow Vitamin, okay? They're the PMS gummy vitamins, and they have a few different things in there to basically, it's like a dietary supplement, and it helps basically alleviate any bloating, crankiness, carb cravings, like anything like that before your period. And I will have to say that last week, although I was emotional, but I mean, who wouldn't be with everything going on in the United States right now? Although I was emotional, I asked David, and he didn't immediately say that I was less crazy, but I felt like I was less crazy. So then I usually get right before my period. Usually I'm like this, and I'm like ordering all the different takeout, and I'm eating all the chocolate. The biggest thing that I noticed is that I'm actually not bloated. Like, I was only bloated for maybe a few hours, and that's it. But usually I'm like bloated for like a whole week before my period. Did not get bloated at all. Didn't even realize my period was coming until it happened. And I have to thank these vitamins for that. They're about $25 a bottle, which is pretty pricey. I saw this like on Facebook. It's probably the first time I've ever like ordered something random off Facebook. But I'm so, so happy I did, and I'm on my second bottle. It just arrived, and it literally wrote, like, literally came to the dot when I was done with these ones. So I'm gonna keep on monitoring it, but so far, so good. Here is another Tree Hut scrub. This is the Vitamin C Shea Sugar Scrub. I prefer the other one because, again, this one doesn't have as much grit. So if you don't like that gritty feeling in your scrubs, then you would like something like this instead. But, I mean, this one has vitamin C, so it's, you know, supposed to brighten the skin, etc., etc. But I really, really love the mocha one better. I might gravitate towards this one more in like the spring and summertime, because it is more of like a springy, citrusy scent. But other than that, I prefer the other one. I love Maui Moisture products. You guys already know this if you've been here for a while. I love this mask. This mask is incredible. I love it for my natural hair. When I take my weave out once a month, I like deep condition. I get everything up in there, and we like detox the scalp. And then on top of it, then I top it with this, and I just treat my curls with it. This is my go-to hair care line for when I wear my hair outside of my weave. In addition to that, they do have body washes too. I did like this body wash, but I will say it, like, the scent, I got so bored of it after a while that I like found myself using other ones instead. But I do like this body wash too. It lathers up really nicely. It's not as thick as the Native one. This one's a little bit more hydrating, but it has shea butter in it, so that makes sense. But I do love their products. Wanted to show you guys a candle. It's been a while since I've used up a candle, and this one smells incredible. So this is the Voluspa. I don't even know how to pronounce it. I'm not going to pretend to know what it's like. The Branche Vermeil. I totally butchered that. But it has silver cypress, cedar, and pine needle. It smells like heaven on earth for the holidays. And so I burn this all throughout the Christmas season. You guys, it smells so, so good. So definitely gonna repurchase this next year for the holidays. I have another candle that I used up. This is Eggnog Latte. I loved this candle. It's very lightweight, you know, has a good like neutral scent. It smelled really, really nice, but I love these Opal House candles from Target. So I'm just ordered more for Valentine's Day, and I'm really excited to see what those ones smell like too. And if they're like that's like sweet scent. I'm about to burn the other ones today. I do not want to forget to burn them, so I'm gonna burn them today, but I really, really love the Opal House ones from Target. Here is something that I highly recommend everybody go try. It's Hot Toddy Heat Protectant Mist. I love this mist from Drybar. Drybar products smell so good, but the hot toddy in particular I just love because it has the heat protection for your hair, but at the same time it is not going to add shine. It's like a nice fine mist. You don't have to worry about it weighing the hair down. It is incredible and I highly recommend it. Last body product, this is the Tahitian Vanilla Bean Moisturizing Shave Oil. Love this stuff, already repurchased it. If you have not tried this, you need to. This is like life-changing, okay? And I don't say that about a shave oil or a shave gel or any kind of shaving anything, but this is life-changing. If you have not tried it, you need to. So I went through quite a bit of makeup this round, I would say. Quite a bit of makeup. I did declutter everything, so these are things that I either was about to get rid of or like had one or two uses left out of, and so I used them and now we're getting rid of them. So oh my gosh, just got this literally everywhere. This is one of the reasons why I didn't like it, actually. I like the formula of this, but the Milani iTac Extreme Liquid Eyeliner literally pops off, like the cap pops off all the time, and it drove me insane. It was a good liquid liner, but not something to write home about. I did go through the Winky Luxe liquid eyeliner. This one has less of a flexible tip than you would expect, and it dried out a little bit quicker than I wanted to, so I probably wouldn't repurchase. I would repurchase the Milani one if it were like on super sale or something. And then my favorite one is the Urban Decay Perversion Waterproof Fine Point. Sad to see this one go. This might have a little bit of juice left in it. I might try and get a few more uses out of that one, but I really, really love that one. Such a good liquid liner. Something that I absolutely hated is the e.l.f. Precision Ultra Precise Brow Pencil. You guys, I don't know if I got it dud, but it like will not, like it literally just keeps breaking off and it will not work for me. Like I have to get everything in me to get it to work. So this guy, I don't know, I might try and buy another one at one point and, you know, try it again, but this was not my jam. Couple concealers that I went through. This is the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. And although I loved it, this was so dark on me. I don't know why I thought I was the shade Biscuit. So I don't know what shade I am, but this is way too dark for me for underneath my eyes. So it's been a hot second since I have really tried it. I liked it, but I feel like the drugstore is really upping their game with under eye concealers. So I mean, with the combination of it being too old, not the right shade, and I felt like it kind of slipped sometimes, it's not my favorite concealer in the world, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of it. I might try it again one day, but I mean, it's not like a holy grail or anything, but on the contrary, I love the Urban Decay All Nighter Concealers. You guys, these are incredible. They lasted forever. There's so much product in there. A little goes a long way. It is completely waterproof. It does not crease. I love, love, love this. Such a good shade range too. And I am in the shade, I have medium dark warm and medium dark neutral. And I use them for probably the last year or so. And I love them in all different shades, undertones, etc. It's such an incredible concealer. So if you haven't tried the Urban Decay one, I highly recommend it. Here's another item I would definitely never repurchase. This is the e.l.f. Putty Eye Primer. I hate this stuff. It's horrible. And you know what? Let me just plug this right now too. I did not like the e.l.f. Putty blushes either. I returned it. I love my Morphe 2 whipped blush. You know that whipped one? I'm actually wearing it right now. Do not like the e.l.f. Putty. And I don't know. I love the Putty like primer, but I don't know if it's just me. Is it just me? I don't know. But this I thought might be a dupe for my MAC Paint Pot, because I always put MAC Paint Pot on before I put eyeshadow on. It's not. It was a waste of money. I'm throwing it out. It dried up super quick. It's super crusty. Absolutely do not like it. Do not recommend. A couple makeup primers. So highly recommend both of these. The Too Faced Hangover is one of my absolute favorites. It has alpine rose extract in it and coconut water. Super hydrating. It feels so good on the skin. It's like drinking water for your skin, like a breath of fresh air for your skin. I love this stuff. And then I was really impressed by the ColourPop Pretty Fresh collection in general. I absolutely love it, but it's their hyaluronic acid collection. I love the concealer, I love the foundation, I love the setting spray, and this is the primer. Highly recommend the primer. I would definitely repurchase, although I don't need to because I do have another backup of the Too Faced, but I would definitely recommend this one if you haven't and haven't tried it and you're looking for a hydrating primer from the drugstore. I love this one. Something that I did not like that's not even completely done and I'm getting rid of it, it's the Dewy Setting Mist by e.l.f. I tried to love this so much, but I think the scent is just too much for me. I love coconut setting, scented anything, and I did not like this scent. It just smells like chemicals to me. Yeah, it's just too, it, like originally I loved it and now I just don't like it. So I'm gonna toss this. It has like probably, I did like 2/3 of the way, but I have better setting sprays than this one. And I don't know. And I will say, I do love e.l.f. products. I feel like I'm like really ragging on them right now. Like there's multiple things that I did not like this time around, but I do really love e.l.f. products. So e.l.f., I love you. I'm sorry. Just not those. Just not those, girl. All right. The Inky List Hyaluronic Acid. Really like this serum. It feels so good on the skin. Really helps hydrate the skin. It's like their first step, but I did use it with other things, but I do recommend it. If you can get your hands on it, I feel like it's super hard to find in stock. And then Pixi Milky Tonic. This has jojoba milk and oat soothing toner. This is a good toner. I wouldn't say it's like anything special, but if you have really sensitive skin, then this might be a good toner for you because it does help hydrate and just neutralize the skin. And it did really help when my skin was like freaking out in the beginning of fall before I started Accutane. All right, you guys, oh my gosh, we're almost done. The final countdown. So this is Too Faced Born This Way powder, and you guys, I have to say, this is one of my favorite powders. I love this to death. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's literally none left. I would definitely repurchase this. I have way too many powders right now, though, but I would definitely repurchase this in a heartbeat. Love it. And that was the shade Translucent, so just the original translucent shade, but it does not dry my skin out. I can use it underneath my eyes. I can use it all over. It is so, so good. This is the Urban Decay All Nighter Summer Solstice. Love this scent. Unlike the e.l.f. one, this smelled like the beach, but like, it smells so good. Like, it's just like a nice neutral scent. I think this was a limited edition, but hopefully they bring it back next year because it does smell like the beach, like kind of like a mixture of coconutty and sand and SPF all in one, and I really, really loved it. Bad Gal Bang. Love this mascara. I will say I probably won't use another one for a while because I do really love that new Sky High from Maybelline, but I do love this mascara. This is the only probably high-end mascara that I've loved in the last few years. And then I just wanted to show you guys that I am on my, gosh, is this month three? I think I'm on like month three of Accutane. So I did, for whatever reason, put this in the empties. I need to film an updated Accutane journey video. So thumbs this up if you want me to do that. But yeah, that is everything, you guys. That is my empties for winter time. I cannot believe, like, it feels so weird that it's already winter. It feels like it's fall still. Like, 2020, I can't even believe it's 2021, to be honest. Like, it just doesn't feel like it's 2021. But with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and let you guys go. If you enjoyed this video, do not forget to hit that big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe before you go. Head on over to Instagram and hang out with me over there, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!